25th Street. I just happened to walk in and noticed they were having an exhibition of recent Jim Dine paintings. So we'll take a look around, see if we can catch some pictures before they shut us down. This is titled Becoming Gray Utopia 2012. Acrylic and sand on canvas, and it's 8 by 8 feet. Now, I've already walked through the show once, and I noticed he's got it broken down into black and whites, and then the color pieces. And out of the black and whites, he's got them kind of segmented here.
Anyway, he said, like,
this is a very well-attended opening. This is titled, It's the End of the Evening, May-June 2011. And this is kind of a departure for Dine. I've been looking through these paintings, wondering if there were some kind of images in there, but mostly this is straight Russian abstraction. I think the other thing that's kind of notable is that it's using a lot of sand in there, so it gets a real nappy texture. This is titled Dark Hearts and a Rope. I don't know if any of you that are Jim Dine fans, you know that he painted hearts for years, and I remember seeing his last show at Pace up on 57th Street. It's been 5 or 6 years ago, and that was all hearts. This piece is 96 by 96, and it's $325,000. Get up and take a little closer look here. It's a wonderful gallery to show big paintings in. This is a huge painting. September 2012, and this is a 9-foot square, and I don't know, it's kind of interesting. It gets a great patina on these. It almost looks like they were painted outside. I was kind of reminded of Ernst Wilhelm Ney's paintings, but you know, a lot of people have criticized Dine for his his impetuousness. Geez, great chance for a photo op. Titled The Skeleton of Time. It's got some circles scratched in there. I kind of like his little dots he's put in. Gets a lot of mileage out of his earth tones. It's a long horizontal piece. Call called A Fingerprint of Stars, 2011 to 2012. This is 5 by 14 feet. And you can have this baby for $350,000. They're kind of alone in the corner here. This is titled A Large Radiance. And here again we've got the segmentation with these vertical lines. It's 72 by 72. Yeah, he's got some kind of comb or something he's using to put on some of his sand textures with. Take a final lap around the back room. This is a very attractive vertical piece. On Yakima Street. This is 7 by 5 feet, and I think that Dine does get a lot of mileage out of his blacks, grays, and browns, and he does a lot of this, tends to go back towards the darker end of the spectrum, but sort of uses that to highlight his brilliant colors. This little slab of turquoise I was looking at. Very chunky stuff. Paparazzi painting fans down here. It's titled A Child in Winter Sings. This is actually a diptych. Interesting. So he's actually got the split between the canvases, but then he's kind of reinforced that with another horizontal line on the right-hand canvas. And that's 2 4-by-8-foot canvases. I'm going to wrap up looking at this piece. This is titled A Beautiful Exchange of Warfare. This is one of the few pieces where he works on a white ground. Some nice little details here and there. I guess you can't paint as long as Jim Dine has been painting without picking up a few nice technical artistic things. So this has been a brief run-through of Jim Dine, some of his recent paintings. Great Pace Gallery, 534 West 25th Street in Chelsea. Thank you, Kate. Thank you.